Hey everyone, we're talking about something super important in JavaScript, the const keyword. So grab your coffee, tea, or snack, and let's break it down. First things first, const was introduced in ES6 back in 2015, and it stands for, yep, you guessed it, constant. In simple terms, once you assign a value to a const variable, you cannot change it. If you try to reassign it, JavaScript will throw an error faster than you can say bug fix. See? The error happens because const variables are immutable, meaning their value can't be changed after the initial assignment. Here's what you need to know about const variables. Like let, they cannot be redeclared, but also, they cannot be reassigned. They have block scope just like let, and they must be assigned a value when declared. See that? You must assign a value when you declare a const variable, otherwise JavaScript won't be happy. Now here's where things get a little tricky. Const doesn't freeze objects or arrays, but it does freeze their reference. So you can modify the contents of an array declared with const, but you can't assign a new array to the const variable. This happens because the reference to the array is locked, but the contents of the array are still mutable or changeable. The same rule applies to objects. You can change their properties, but you can't reassign the entire object. The reason is again that const locks the reference, not the values inside the object. Now let's compare var, let, and const real quick. As you can see, var is kind of the troublemaker. It gets initialized when hoisting and redeclared everywhere. Not great, but let and const are much more predictable and safer to use. Let's look at a hoisting example with var and then with const. Var is hoisted, which means you can use it before it's even declared. It's undefined and in real-life code, probably not what you intended. But const? Nope. Trying this with const gives you a big fat reference error. This is because const variables are also hoisted, but they are not initialized, meaning you can't access them before their declaration in the code. So, when should you use const? If you know a value won't need to change, go with const. If you know the value will change, go with let. If you're not sure, try const and see if your code breaks. If it does, you might need to change it to let. Once you get more familiar with JavaScript, you'll know when to use each. But as for var, well, maybe just leave that in the past. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe to get notified about our latest videos. For more coding tips and tricks, keep it locked right here on w3schools.com. Don't forget to try out what you've learned in our interactive editor. Happy coding!